We should care if they disappear because we need bees, whether we like them or not. They pollinate most wild plants, everything from apples and strawberries to coffee depends upon bees. So humans would starve without bees.
Hoy tenemos con nosotros a Dave Goulson. Y quiero que recordéis este nombre cuando veáis una abeja, un abejorro. No la espantéis. No la espantéis porque nos estamos quedando sin abejas, sin abejorros y son fundamentales en nuestra vida. Dave Goulson es un biólogo, doctorado en mariposas y que lleva 30 años estudiando y defendiendo las abejas y en concreto los abejorros. Dave, ¿cómo fue tu infancia rodeado de todo tipo de criaturas con alas y sin alas?
I was lucky to grow up in the countryside, and for some reason I was just obsessed by insects from a really early age. I don't know why. I think actually lots of kids love insects given half a chance. I just never grew out of it, and it's been a privilege to spend my whole life chasing around after insects.
Es una suerte para nosotros, porque están en declive en el mundo entero y en toda Europa las abejas y los abejorros.
Sadly, is true. Some species have gone extinct in Europe. 46% of bees have declined. They're in trouble, and it's down to us.
Yo siempre digo, porque me lo contó una vez un entrevistado, un entomólogo, que los insectos se quedan con nuestra cara. Y siempre me dicen, anda ya, qué barbaridades dices. Se lo vuelvo a preguntar a un experto como tú, Dave. ¿Los insectos se quedan con nuestra cara?
Bees most certainly do. I can't speak for all insects, and bees are probably more intelligent than most insects. But there's irrefutable scientific evidence that bees can learn to associate a particular human face with reward, with food. And so they can tell faces apart very reliably. So yes, they can indeed tell, recognize human faces.
¿También saben jugar al fútbol?
not naturally, but scientists have done experiments where they have shown that you can train bumblebees to roll a little ball into a hole if that gives them a sugar reward. It just shows really how amazingly adaptable and intelligent they are.
Son inteligentes, piensan. Haznos una breve síntesis de las abejas y de los abejorros, de sus capacidades. Sorpréndenos.
There are many amazing things about bees. Perhaps their social lives is one of the more remarkable things. They live in a very organized, altruistic colony, which acts more like a kind of single organism, where each bee has its own particular jobs and so on. They're quite amazing. But then individually, they're also capable of astonishing feats of learning and navigation. They have an inbuilt magnetic compass so that they can tell where they're going, even when it's cloudy and they can't see the sun. They're all round pretty amazing little creatures.
Y también unas enseñan a las otras, ¿no? Aprenden las abejas y los abejorros.
They can watch what other bees are doing and learn from them which are the most rewarding flowers. And they also have ways of communicating directly with one another. So famously in honeybees, the relatives of bumblebees, they do the waggle dance, where a bee can carefully explain exactly where and in which direction and how far a good patch of flowers is. And they communicate that by doing a strange dance inside the nest.
Dave, me has convencido. Yo quiero colaborar. Quiero que el mundo no se quede sin abejorros. ¿Qué puedo hacer desde mi cuarto piso en una ciudad polucionada?
Well, you could put a window box and grow some bee-friendly flowers, and that would help if everybody did it. And more broadly, support sustainable farming, buy organic food, buy locally grown food wherever you can, to encourage types of farming that themselves will support more bees. And generally vote for, I would say, vote for politicians that really care and will look out for the environment.
Fantástico. Muchísimas gracias, Dave. Ya tienes una nueva admiradora y seguidora de tu lucha porque los abejorros no desaparezcan. Gracias.
Excellent. Thank you.